Hey lovely people, today I'll be showing you how I prep and set up a romantic sunset picnic in the park. I hope you enjoy this video. If you do, definitely thumbs up, but let's get started. So is it really a picnic if you don't have a picnic basket? So my husband purchased this one from Amazon. Usually we would just throw everything in a bag, but if you want to elevate your picnic experience, I would definitely recommend you purchasing a picnic basket. I love that this one is insulated. It comes with everything you need, from your knives, forks, plates, glasses. So I really think that it's a good investment. So the next 30 seconds is for those of you who find cleaning therapeutic. I took everything out of the picnic basket just to give it a quick clean. It is brand new, and I find that when you buy new products, well, I personally like to just clean them because you never really know what happens to them before they get to you. So, I mean, I might be a little bit OCD, but that's just me. So I'm just cleaning everything and getting it ready, and then I just wiped it all up and put it back in the picnic basket. So next up is the food and flowers. So my husband took a trip to Trader Joe's. I decided I wanted to make a charcuterie board, so he got everything. Well, he got more than enough. But I'm actually gonna be sharing with you guys another video of how to use leftovers to make charcuterie boards. So that's coming up very soon. But anyway, so this is my little prepping station. I decided to just use a square board, and these are some of the cheeses that my husband picked up. So brie is definitely one of my favorite cheeses. Definitely the mushroom brie from, yeah, this one from Trader Joe's. That's one of my favorites. If you haven't tried it already and you're a cheese lover, definitely check it out. So I started by just cubing the cheddar. And I think that when it comes to making charcuterie boards, well, for me, I just like to be creative, and you know, it doesn't have to be perfect. Like, I'm not a professional chef or the founder of the Charcuterie Association, so I'm just like, do whatever makes you happy and make it fun. Next we have prosciutto, definitely another favorite, like with crackers and cheese. Sometimes I will literally just be me and my wine and my cheese watching my favorite show. Like, that's like one of my fave little evening me time things to do. But as you can see, I'm, you know, like, going back to what I was saying, I kind of just like go with the flow with like how I lay everything out, and I definitely love the combination of brie and prosciutto, so that's why I put it that's why I put them next to each other. Next we have the peppered salami. Now that's one of my husband's faves, so I made sure to put a good amount of those on the board as well. I just kind of like fanned them a little. Like, I know there are so many ways to like decorate salami and pepperoni and stuff, but I just wanted to keep it fairly simple for our picnic. And then I moved on to the fruits. I love golden berries. I mean, it was actually something that I had only tried recently. They have a honey flavor, you know, like a typical berry, but like with a little hint of honey. And then obviously the classic grapes. What is a cheese board of any type without grapes? And I love strawberries, so I made sure to add strawberries. And my husband loves blueberries, so we had a, you know, like, I think definitely add some of your favorite fruits. I know people add like apples, peaches, dried fruit as well. I'm not really a fan of dried fruit, so I didn't add any, but make it as colorful and as fruit filled as you like. So then we moved on to the mixed nuts. So I do not like olives at all, but this mixed fruits is so good. I definitely think it's so flavorful, so definitely check it out. And then on to chocolate, a little bit of chocolate or some sweets, definitely add those. And we got two types of chocolate, like a rice crispy type of chocolate, and also just plain milk chocolate as well. Dark chocolate is definitely another option that goes really well with cheese. Now for the spreads, we use an apricot preserve and also use some honey. And if you haven't already, definitely try the combination of brie, honey and prosciutto. It's so good. So that's why I had these plastic containers. I just fill them up. And I think that is really useful as well for, especially when you're traveling, you don't want anything to spill. And I know that like when honey spills, it's one of the most annoying things to clean up. So right now I'm just filling in some of the gaps, and I have chosen the pita bite crackers from Trader Joe's, and I also put those in a container. Next, I cut up some more strawberries that we were gonna add to our wine, and I just put those in a separate container along with some extra grapes, because I love grapes and my husband loves grapes too. So now I just do a quick cleanup, and then I get ready to, you know, pack and get the wine ready and everything like that. But something I wanted to say is, even if you're not in a relationship, I think that having solo picnics are also really nice. Like something that I even want to do more is, you know, like go to the park, bring some snacks, read a book, do those little things for myself. I think that it's important that we don't just see these type of activities as things we have to do with a partner. I think that we are deserving of these moments of bliss and excitement and romance by ourselves too. So I love Moscato, so we decided to go with an Italian Moscato to drink. And now for packing. So I was too afraid to even try to put the charcuterie board in here. I'm sure it could have probably fit, but because it was, you know, like I definitely packed it quite full, so I decided to just do that separately. But now we're gonna move on to the flowers. So we bought the, at Trader Joe's, they do small bunches of flowers for $3.99, and I love that because I think you don't always want to get a bigger bouquet. So we ended up just buying two of those, and I bought the vase from IKEA, which was also I think like $4 or $5, which I thought was a pretty good deal. And the thing about flowers is, I mean, you can bring them to your picnic, but then you can also bring them back home and they're still alive, they're still going strong. So I definitely think that it just adds something beautiful to your picnic, and it just kind of gives it that extra romance. So I almost forgot napkins, and I thought, you know what, just tear off some of those paper towels and call it a day. So at this point, we were good to go, got my flowers, we had our basket. I tried lifting it, it was too heavy. So my husband lifted it. But I wanted to just show you how secure it is. And there's even some buckles on the side where if you had like additional blankets or things, you could just, you know, like put them in the sides. And I just think it's just such a pretty basket. So this is what I ended up doing to the charcuterie board. I just put some foil on top. But yeah, this is the final product. It was so beautiful to just, you know, sit outside, watch the sunset, and just enjoy some of our favorite foods. I really hope that you enjoy this video, and remember what I said, don't forget to romance yourself. Have a wonderful day, night, wherever you are in the world, and I'll see you in my next one. Take care.